think obviously each iteration of Star Trek has given audiences something unique, a little different than what has come before. I'm curious if you can quantify what you think was unique about what Voyager gave to that very rich and diverse universe.
Well, I'm not the first to say it, but Voyager was the most in the spirit of the original series, more so than Next Generation and Deep Space Nine, and I think more so really than the Enterprise, and certainly than the newer iterations like Discovery. There was not just an optimism, but a weekly adventure, a kind of episodic feel about Voyager without doing long character arcs, without developing a sort of a very familiar neighborhood of space the way the Next Generation did, because we were traveling through an uncharted part of space on a kind of a desperate and hopeless mission to get home before we'd all grown too old and died, except for the holographic members of the crew. Because of all those things, Voyager really had the boldly go where no man has gone before spirit of the original series. Also, we're the first series with a captain who's a woman, and that I'm very proud of. It took Doctor Who another 25 years to have their first female doctor. So every time people talked about Doctor Who, you know, being older than the Star Trek franchise or doing it first, I have to remind them how newly non-sexist their status is. The great thing about being part of the Star Trek franchise is that it's optimistic science fiction, with a hope for the future. A lot of post 9/11 science fiction has become very apocalyptic in nature, and it's nice to be. Voyager was in the spirit of we can overcome our differences. I mean, there were certain things that were sophisticated and perhaps slightly even prefigured 9/11. The Voyager was, a banding together of rebels of the Maquis, who were considered terrorists by many, with a Starfleet crew. So our former enemy had to become part of our crew. So it had a message of peace and reconciliation at its core that I think was also great. And it featured, I think, Avery Brooks eventually shaved his head, but I'm the first truly, the Doctor was the first sort of handsome, magnetic, bald man since Patrick Stewart. At least that's the story I'm trying to sell today.